Did you know 1/3 of our food supply requires pollination? You better believe it. Hello everyone, Crystal here for D News, and I'm buzzing about bees. That's right, the honeybee is finally getting noticed for its decreasing workforce and essential role in our economy. The honeybee has been an unsung hero of industry, pollinating our food, producing commercially used wax, and of course, honey. Government estimates suggest that around $15 billion a year of the US economy currently rests on the backs of bees. But there's a big problem. Scientists have known for years that these busy bees are dying off and disappearing in a phenomenon called colony collapse disorder. Originally a term applied to the noticeable reduction in viability of commercial honeybee colonies, there is a growing concern that colony collapse disorder is also affecting wild bee populations. It may not seem like much, but the US honeybee population is currently less than half of what it was 60 years ago, and in some cases, farmers have reported a loss of bee population of 50% within a single year. You may be asking yourself, how many bees do we really need to keep our nation fed? Well, in 2007, the EPA reported that the ever-vulnerable California almond crop requires 1.3 million colonies of bees. The average number of bees per colony is at 50 to 60,000, so that's 78 billion bees for California almonds alone. That's a lot of bees. Now, the problem is getting some high-profile attention from the president himself, who signed a memorandum directing our government agencies to broadly advance honeybee and other pollinator health and habitat. So what factors will most likely be investigated? Well, right now, concerns for honeybee health center around a few major factors. Poor bee nutrition, loss of forage lands, parasites, pathogens, lack of genetic diversity, and exposure to pesticides. Much attention has been paid to the effects of neonicotinoid pesticides on pollinator populations, but the White House memo goes broader, calling for more research on pollinator health and the restoration and enhancement of acres of land for pollinators through combined public and private action. Monarch butterflies also got a shout out, and there's efforts to protect their annual migration and prevent decline of their population. The drastic and inexplicable loss of pollinators has been an intense topic of research for many years, given its interest to farmers and scientists alike. But now, with the spotlight of government interest on it, hopefully it will be possible to design new and effective means to address this critical issue. What can you do to help short of raising bees yourself? Well, you can plant flowers in your yard, don't use pesticides to keep them pretty, and spend some of that disposable income on local honey. Supporting your friendly neighborhood beekeeper could keep food in your mouth in more ways than one. What do you think? Should the government be concerned about bees? Subscribe to D News and let us know in the comments down below. And for more on bees and colony collapse disorder, head on over to this video.
33% of all the honeybee colonies in the US die. That is double the acceptable natural amount, and entomologists are warning that we're getting dangerously close to the point where we don't have enough bees to meet our country's pollination demands.
Thanks for watching.